What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about wheel rims and how they affect a car's drag. So as we all know, a car has these wheels, four wheels obviously. Some have three, I guess, others have six, but generally speaking, four. And these wheels have different rim designs, so you can have different spoke patterns. So how does these spoke patterns affect the car's drag? Well, I actually spent a few years investigating this for a European car manufacturer, and these are the results that I found. So we're going to go through a few things. First of all, the coverage area, because this is the most important parameter. So let's say you have one wheel and you cover the entire surface. That is going to be far more, that's going to be far more aerodynamic than a wheel that isn't covered. So you have all these openings between these rims. You have these two openings here. So going from a completely open wheel to a completely closed wheel, you will change the drag coefficient by about 20 to 25 counts. So that's quite a lot when you think about a car these days, their drag coefficient is around 0.25 to 0.3. So you're actually reducing the drag or changing the drag by up to 10% for a lot of these cars just by changing it from a very open wheel, a rim, to a very closed rim. And obviously the rims need to have some amount of spokes in there just for structural integrity, obviously. So bare minimum, you'll reduce the drag coefficient by 25 counts going to a completely closed rim, completely covered. Now, in addition to that, it also depends on where you put the openings. So let's say you have a wheel like this, and you have the inside part completely covered, and then you have the spokes coming out, and then the outside part completely open. Is that going to give the same amount of drag as a rim, which is completely open in the middle, so the spokes coming here, and then completely closed on the outside, if the coverage areas are exactly the same? So the opening areas are exactly the same, and the coverage areas are exactly the same. They're just redistributed in different ways. Will this give the same drag changes? The answer is no, actually. Covering the outside of the wheel is far more effective at reducing the drag than covering the inside. And in fact, generally speaking, it's like, let's say you get 5 count reduction here, you get a 10 count reduction here, or 15 count reduction here. That's how much better it is. So the problem with covering the wheels completely though is you need to have some amount of cooling flow for the brakes. So ideally, actually, the brakes benefit the most from having the rims open on the outside. That's where you get the most cooling flow from. But that is the worst for aerodynamics because you want to cover the outside. So you have this balancing act going on here. The final thing I want to talk about is, well, the number of spokes affect how much drag you get. Well, generally speaking, no. So if you have one rim design where you have like 10, 15 spokes, and then you have another rim design where you only have 5, but the amount of coverage area for this rim is exactly the same as this rim, the drag will pretty much be completely the same. In fact, it's within the area of the wind tunnel. So you can't actually tell a difference. So the number of spokes that you have don't really affect the flow. The design of the spokes do affect the flow. So if you have a fan blade design, like a lot of Teslas have, where they're sort of pivoted out and they go along, and it's sort of like a fan or a turbine, that does affect the drag. That's actually very bad because you're actually blowing air out one side and pulling air on the other side of the car. That's quite bad for drag. But all these rim designs will lie between the completely closed rim and the completely open rim. So they lie within a 20-25 count change for the car, whether you have this many rim spokes, this many spokes, completely open on the outside, completely covered on the inside, completely open on the inside, completely covered on the outside, etc. So the best rims are these rims here, where they're completely closed. The worst rims are these ones here, and also arguably the ones with the fan spokes as well. My research showed that having the turbine, these fan rims, are, even though they have quite a lot of coverage area, are actually just as bad as having a very open rim, and you're getting like a 20 count increase in the drag just from these things. So those are the worst rims. So that is the end of this video. If you'd like to, make sure to like it and click the subscribe button. And if you'll see more like this, watch this video here, and I'll see you next video. Peace out, amigos.